Well, let's hit the start button on the oven and let's get roasty. We've got our four victims, volunteers playing along tonight. And while we expect plenty of cheap shots, snarkiness, catcalls, petty observations, keep in mind that it's all in good fun. These four all know, like, and respect each other and are willing to participate. Will they feel differently afterwards? Let's see how hot it gets. Ladies and gentlemen, his throne awaits. So we'll bring out this evening's main course. We're talking about no one other than the Sultan of Stick, the master of chatter, a geek we all love to tweak, the birthday boy himself, Paul M. Neuberger. And now, let's welcome the mistress of mayhem, the priestess of property and casualty, the goddess of Greenfield, and the real leader of the Star Group, Mary Star.
I'm pretty sure I've forgotten why I'm standing in front of this podium right now. One thing I know for sure, I have got to get better at telling one certain person no when he asks me for a favor. So, should we get this over with?
Yeah.
Actually, let me rephrase that. Let's get started. Couldn't be more thrilled to be here with that guy with the camera right there. I don't know what this is over here. But as I look around, it actually looks a little bit more like the old props from Mr. Paul's broken film career. So, if you have not figured out by now, my name is Mary Starr, and I am Paul's boss. And I am sorry to disappoint you, but there will be no roast this evening. And there will be no roast for one particular reason. That is because you cannot organize your own roast. Because organizing your own roast would be like organizing your own birthday party. Either you are insanely desperate for attention, or incredibly egotistical, or, you know, actually, I get it now.
Yeah?
I understand. I get it. So let's see. Paul asks his pastor, his ex-comic best friend, and his boss, who has no extensive public speaking experience, to roast him tonight. He sure knows how to make himself look good for his career. So, either I will succeed tonight, or Paul's year in bonus will be three big pens and a rolling blade. Not even kidding.
I didn't think this out very well.
So, a businesswoman, a comic, and a pastor walk into a bar and immediately fall over laughing when they see Paul Neuberger order his sixth vanilla cutty.
Where's Nick?
So I've known Paul for almost 4 years, and he likes to joke about the fact that I could be his mother. A joke that only has legs because I am far too good looking to be his sister. And I'm sorry, I heard she was in the audience. I'm sorry, I didn't know that. A lot of people also joke about the fact that Paul looks a lot older than he actually is. But the truth of the matter is they are actually just being polite. Because what Paul actually looks like is a Cabbage Patch Kid. He's always got that tiny smirk plastered on his enormous face, and his hands are stitched together, ready to point at the next cell phone camera.
She's bringing them out.
Because, in fact, if Paul were a Cabbage Patch Kid, he would come prepackaged in that goofy little heart suit that would be impossible to get off, especially in public. Oh, yeah. The truth is, I always tell people that Paul is more like a father to me. A much older father, one I have to look after to make sure he doesn't roll down a flight of stairs while checking his LinkedIn stats on his cell phone.
Guilty. Guilty.
Paul's social media presence is not to be overlooked. Mostly because that would be next to impossible. Everyone in this room has logged into LinkedIn at one point or another and wondered if they had been hacked by Paul Neuberger. In fact, every non-Paul post that I land on is sandwiched between his costume-clad body and the shiny gleam of his forehead.
90.
He loves to post inspirational stories, job tips, and my own personal favorite, a video that recommends everyone simply wrestle with their kids as their primary form of exercise. Although Paul is noticeably absent on Snapchat, and I can only assume it's because of the amount of costumes that he wears that makes him an instant Snapchat filter. Paul has over 10 million followers on social media. And over 15 million decibels to his voice at 8 a.m. in the morning. Conference calls with Paul are like watching Netflix on a Tuesday night, and that it's always set to the lowest possible volume, and I'm mostly looking for the right opportunity to use the bathroom. Half the time, or actually most of the time, I don't even pick up the phone when Paul calls. Instead, I watch YouTube videos of geese mating to get the same effect. Not even kidding. I paid Paul more than I would have liked when he started with the Star Group.
You got a deal.
But the truth is, I knew we would get it back because the reflection of the office light off his forehead would save us a fortune in electric bills. Paul's forehead is so big, it has its own parking spot.
It's a 5-minute.
In fact, when I see him out of the corner of my eye coming down the hall at the office, sometimes I think we hired a stormtrooper in a dinner jacket. And then I realize, oh, that's just Paul. So Paul does have a tendency to overcommit. And as he took the stage as the 2018 president of the Heart Walk, without hesitation, he committed to an amount almost double what anyone had ever raised before. And just like the small daughter he brought to his interview and left with the receptionist, I messed my pants a little bit too. But he still raised over a $500,000 more than any previous person had ever raised before. So on a more serious note, this brings me to what I respect about Paul the most. His relentless pursuit of excellence and his persistent willingness to dream big. And while it is easy to poke fun at you, Paul, you are truly one of a kind. With all of your amazing accomplishments and your unnatural tendency to wake up early and send me a dozen emails by 4 a.m.,
you too.
You are truly more than an older looking brother or a father to me. You are truly like a grandfather. Actually, an older, senile grandfather. One that wears a suit 7 days a week, tells cheesy jokes that are solely for the entertainment of himself, argues with his Korean neighbor, and won't stop giving me advice I don't ask for. So I would like to thank you, Paul, for allowing me to share my true thoughts and feelings. It has truly been cleansing. Let me rephrase that. It has truly been an honor.
Moving forward, please give a rousing welcome to a man with a holy plan, a dean of the local church scene, the earthbound bod with direct line to God, and a commando from heaven for all you branded 777, Pastor Joel Howard.
So I guess the first thing is, they don't train you to do this at seminary. There's no roasting 101 class. But first, I need to give you some thank yous. So I'm just going to start off with thank you, because you like to be thanked.
Love to be thanked.
A lot. Yes. So first of all, thank you for letting us go first, because if we had gone second, we would never have gotten a word in. Right? Thank you for giving up some of your 60 minutes of talking and spreading that out among the three of us, because I know that was your original plan, was a 60-minute monologue, right?
It was.
Because you like to hear yourself talk. And I know it's hard not to grab this mic right now. I can see you twitching, right? Right? You're like, oh, it's right there, I can grab it. Kind of like when you came to the concert at Grace and said, hey, if you need me to introduce the concert tonight, just ask me, I'll stand up and talk. And said, I'd like to have Mark Schultz actually sing tonight. So. The nice thing, too, is I saw the agenda. When I saw the agenda, I don't know if you saw the agenda for tonight, but every 5 minutes, we're supposed to get a 30-second LinkedIn break. And we post on LinkedIn. And then we need another 30 seconds so that Paul, on his many different accounts, can like and comment on his own posts from his other accounts. In fact, I think 90% of your likes and comments are just from yourself. Just hopping on different accounts. But I have to be honest, thank you, because this is like every pastor's dream. You get to rip on one of your members and not get in trouble for it. He asks for it. I mean, And normally we try to preach people to heaven. Today we get to burn you. But as I was thinking about your birthday, man, I was thinking about what would Paul have been like as a child? Good luck, Mom and Dad. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry. So probably waking you guys up at 4 a.m., delegating the task of setting up the lemonade stand every day, while Paul is running his paper route, walking dogs, mowing lawns, and coming back to make sure his parents have made enough sales.
Sounds about right.
Yeah. Sitting down with them afterwards as they're counting their money and going, all right, we need to talk about how you can instantaneously differentiate this lemonade stand from the one right down the road. Right? How are we going to cold call every single one of these houses so that they will buy your lemonade and you can just get in the door? Just get in the door. I was listening. I've been studying. Walking them through how to do it, right? And cold call coaching, man, when I first heard you were doing that, I'm like, man, that is interesting. What is cold call coaching all about? So I actually took the time to watch some of your videos. Huh? I know.
I'm shocked.
Impressed. Yeah. So, and I totally get why people buy from you. Totally get why people buy from you. Man, you just talk them to death. They're like, just relax, slow down, you wore me out, you have too much energy, I want to go take a nap, I'll buy one of everything. Right? Like you don't even have to tell them your story, you just keep talking them, right? And they'll get it. And I love the fact that as I was looking up what you do for cold call coaching, there was even one talking about how you taught Reagan how to use the phone to cold call coach, didn't you?
I did.
And she keeps picking up these remote controls and talking into them as if she's talking on the phone, kind of like her dad at all hours of the day. And I guess you probably tell them as you tuck them into bed at night, just make sure you add value to this family. Just make sure you add value to this family. That's why Paul gets so much done. It's not because he's doing it. He's got his kids doing it already. So speaking of cold call coaching, I started thinking about, Paul, how many businesses do you actually have?
Lots,
that's right. So Paul's business, you know, Star Group that he serves at, Cold Call Coaching, C-Suite for Christ, Young Guns, Paul Neuberger Incorporated, Paul Neuberger LCC, Paul Neuberger and Associates, do any anymore? Just keep listening, okay, all right. I'm like, how many, this is like Pokemon, gotta catch them all, right? How many are you gonna actually have? I think you have as many businesses as you do crazy suits and socks.
Yeah.
Probably. Yes. So, but I know it's important to you to be successful, hardworking, a go-getter, to connect, to network with so many people. And I know probably one of the great difficulties for you as you network is when a person says, hey, Paul, can I get your business card? Because that moment, you probably have to think in your head, which one? Do you want the cold call coaching business card? Do you want the? So I got this for you, so you can fit all your business cards in here and any more you want in the future. So this is to hold all your business cards.
Wow,
very good. There you go. So, yeah. There you go. Useful. Absolutely. So, and even your trademark, because, you know, Paul is obviously not complete without his own personal trademark, so everyone knows it's him. In fact, I got an email from Paul the other day, and the day before that, and the day before that, and I think four the day before that. And I was reading through it to see what was going on and what he had to blabber on and on about that day. And I got to the end of it, and the end of his email was like the beginning of a Star Wars movie. Because his signature just keeps going on and on and on and on. And like, how many different things do I have to read about you?
Not enough.
And I don't know if you heard, but Paul has a new book coming out. Right? I don't know if you heard about that. If you didn't, it's because you're not on LinkedIn, Facebook, social media. I haven't talked to Paul in about a year. So, but if you know about it, then you know about Paul's new book, right? And you know that he's been trying to figure out what is the cover for his new book going to look like, because he has these three great options. But I actually found out that he had a first option that he wanted to show. And let me show you Paul's first submission of the very first cover for his book. Right there. It's just Paul's face.
I like it.
Yeah, I know you would.
That's good.
It is by Paul, starring Paul, with pictures of Paul.
Pre-order at the door.
Pre-order at the door. And I helped you out. There's a subtitle for it. It's Just Sell Yourself. If that doesn't work, sell me. And he's going to have a second book coming out, I heard, right? It's a second book?
Not probably.
That's what I heard. It's this one. Don't worry, I can monetize that. Because my beautiful mug can sell anything. So if you don't understand that one, whenever I talk to Paul, for some reason, he always has to talk about his mug, his beautiful mug. I'm like, all right, so where am I going to get pictures of that mug? And I said, oh, well, Facebook. So I went on Facebook to find some pictures of his mug and found 50 pictures that Paul had taken. And then I found 50 pages of pictures of Paul. Because you can never have enough pictures of Paul.
That's all you found.
So I wanted to make sure that he is always reminded of how beautiful of a mug he has. So I got him a mug that says, Hello, Beautiful.
Yeah.
And I can't imagine that, and I know you don't need coffee with your energy, but I cannot imagine the amount of energy it takes to be in your household. So, not for you, because you don't need this, but this is for your wife. It is a six-pack of 5-hour energy drink. God bless you. And then last, and it's not something nice to say about you. They're the nice people, not me, not as your pastor. So, yeah. And if you saw the agenda, Paul has a big surprise at the end. But I'm going to spoil it because I found out what it was. I know. So you won't have to get up here and talk, don't worry. So Paul is kicking off his presidential campaign. And I know the first thing he's going to do on his presidential campaign is he's going to start by instantaneously differentiating America. Then he's going to cold call every foreign leader to sell them on himself. And then he's going to show his campaign, which is this. Paul Neuberger for president, making America memorable again.
Yeah, love it.
And to that end, I have his first campaign poster. Happy birthday, Paul.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joel Howard.
Thank you. Great job. Well done.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, finally, we bring you a guy who's never shy, a comic as smooth as ceramic, the man who's funny without being sunny, and everybody's friend from West Bend, ladies and gentlemen, Gary Luke.
Good evening, everyone. How you guys doing? Welcome to Paul's Roast. Do you guys recognize this jacket?
Yes.
Saw it on LinkedIn. I got it. I kiped it from his house. Stole it last night. It was sweet. Broke in. Got by his guard dog. Tonight for tonight's roast, I thought I would just kind of switch it up. There were so many angles to take. There were literally like thousands to take. So I thought what I would do is do an a live impersonation of a Paul LinkedIn post.
Yeah. You got me curious, Lou.
Good evening. Hashtag Paul Loomer here. Hashtag president of the Star Group. Hashtag I'm here at the roast at the hashtag Tuckaway Country Club. Hashtag thank you so much for coming to this dinner. Hashtag with a bunch of leaders. Hashtag so just so you know, I want to tell you my family history. So hashtag my wife Tanya is here, and then hashtag I have a family. And so what happened was, because I wasn't bored enough, I decided to hashtag become the president, hashtag of the cold call coach. But I'm not only hashtag the president, I'm the hashtag CEO, and I'm the hashtag founder of the cold call coach. But I found myself having a lot of hashtag free time, so suddenly I found myself saying, I'm gonna start something that's hashtag something about faith. So suddenly I found myself starting hashtag see super Christ. So nice, you know, hashtag blessings upon you. We now, 1 year later, are 1 year hashtag anniversary. So January 5th, I'm doing a plug for you here. But January 15th, hashtag if you're not there, Melissa Young hashtag will be there to speak at the Grace Lutheran Church hashtag with hashtag Pastor Joel Howard. So that's just see super Christ. So what I did is I found myself really bored again, hashtag, because I had to spare time with my wife and C-Suite for Christ, and then I've been the president of the Star Group, and now I have all these different things going on, that I thought, hashtag, I'm going to start Young Guns. Hashtag Young Guns. Here comes a plug. February 27th, hashtag, there's going to be the Young Guns, because, I'm using Paul's voice, I'm not a millennial, because all you non-millennials like me are idiots. And us hashtag millennials are going to teach you non-millennials why you're all idiots. Again, I'm not a millennial. I'm speaking on Paul's behalf. So just in my hashtag spare time, I've been doing Young Guns, C-Suite, and all these different things. Believe everything is trending. January 15th, I'm trending. February, I own January. I own LinkedIn.
Yes.
Are we clear? And I just started. Recently, I was, of course, named chairman, hashtag chairman, of the hashtag American Heart Association. And you might have seen me a few times on my hashtag heart jacket, and we raised a lot of hearts, and we had a hashtag a lot of money. So we've done those things in my hashtag spare time. So unlike Joel, he is running for president, but I recently heard we have an announcement, hashtag announcement, that Paul has been just recently named hashtag chairman of the moon. Hashtag. I'm not sure if you've heard, the moon has finally realized who, what kind of talent we have. Hashtag blue cheese. Always been a lie. It's always been in books. You've heard all about it. But hashtag blue cheese is all over the moon. And hashtag Paul is going to mine it. Now, we are booking flights sometime around 21, hashtag 2022, to get your own slice of hashtag blue cheese, but you gotta get on for board down soon to the hashtag Paul Newberger Lunar Module launching in 2022. But finally, before I close, because I had a stroke 2 years ago and I'm right now on the brink of another one, is that we're now launching our new line of hashtag really bad ugly jackets. And what I will say is, we're gonna launch our latest, let me get near Paul so you see these crazy hashtag clown socks he wears. I am not a clown sock guy, but this guy's like hashtag clown socks. See, I knew it. So coming in 2023, once you get done getting blue cheese, hashtag blue cheese on the moon, hashtag, you can get your really ugly jacket and your hashtag socks. That's all I got for you guys tonight. Thank you. Guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Lube. And now, the man of the hour, the roastee, the birthday boy, Mr. Paul M. Newberger.
Now it's my turn. Seriously, is that the best you got? I'm really let down. was expecting a far worse beatdown. I figured my self-esteem would be so low, I'd be looking up at ants. In fact, I planned to go right to a costume store and buy a mask. Because I figured I wouldn't be able to show my face around here for a long, long time. Friends, I'm the epitome of a target-rich environment for mocking, jokes, and ridicule. And that's all these three could come up with? Well, this is gonna be fun. Oh, does this place have a bowling alley? I feel like I'm bowling, only with 3 pins instead of 10. Just knock them all down. And I plan to do so in the order that they aim their pop guns at me. Let's start with Mary Starr. Oh, yeah. What can you say about Mary Starr?
Nothing.
Moving on. Alex gets a raise now. Yeah. Mary Starr, I love her like, well, my boss. She's a woman of many talents and a few peculiarities, many of which you might not be made aware of. You look at Mary, and you can't help but notice she's very healthy. Well, there's a reason. Mary is what we normal people call a fitness freak. And I say this, of course, in only the most complimentary manner. How much of a fitness freak is she? Well, we don't start our Monday morning management meetings at the Star Group until 8:15 a.m. because Mary is working out. Now, as many of you know, for me, that's practically the middle of the day. I'm busy working on the bottom line while Mary is still working on her glutes and abs. Yes, Mary's quite the fitness devotee. In fact, there's a related urban legends in the halls of the Star Group. Supposedly, one time, Mary got upset with an employee.
No.
Really upset. Oh, she came down hard on him. Instead of putting a letter of reprimand in his file, she made him do 50 push-ups. No word, though, on whether she made him go to her health club the next day. Would she really be that harsh? That's a joke. There it is. But this doesn't completely explore the depth of Mary's obsession with being fit. Let's use a more visual analogy if we can. You know how superheroes always have a secret identity? You know, when a crisis erupts, they find a dark corner, tear off their clothes, and reveal their superhero costume beneath. Well, if Mary was a superhero, her costume would be a tracksuit. Actually, Mary is quite fond of costumes. Let's enjoy a few she's worn in recent years. Her Michael Jackson outfit made me want to beat it, all right. Right out the door. Her Alice in Wonderland deserves props, though. I mean, how can anyone look at the Mad Hatter and possibly be mad at her? Come on!
Don't put your face up.
You see what I did there, Phil Hewson? Yeah, that was a good one. I know that's probably a little over your head, but whatever. All right, anyway, we mentioned Mary's superhero tracksuit a moment ago. Well, you probably saw photos or videos of the heart suit I wore to promote the American Heart Association Heart Walk a few months ago. And of course, there's two of me, go figure. Well, did you know that Mary bought a matching suit? No lie. Yes, you did. I was flattered, of course, but also perplexed. I mean, Mary, if you're in search of a heart, most people would probably consult a healthcare professional, not their tailor. But staying on this theme, Mary was kind enough to help with several videos I did for the Heart Association Heart Walk. She saved me some time, too. You see, I no longer have to wonder about what I'll get for her birthday this year. If you watch those videos, you'll notice Mary says amazing a lot. No, more than a lot, like constantly.
It's going to be an amazing event. It is going to be an amazing year.
Crazy stuff
amazing.
That you're not going to want to miss.
What could be better than that, Mary Star?
And guess what? Nothing, because you know what? It's going to be amazing.
Absolutely amazing!
So please join me in welcoming to the stage the one and only, the amazing Paul Newberger. Amazing.
$20,000 in donations.
Amazing. 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 Amazing.
Absolutely amazing!
The amazing.
So her birthday gift is obvious. I just have to buy it. Can anyone give me advice on wrapping the thesaurus? As well as she did in those videos, though, Mary is very self-conscious about being on camera. She needs her talking points well in advance.
Yes.
Like Monday. Yep. I got an email on Wednesday. What are we talking about on Monday? Otherwise, she's more nervous than a cat in a tail stomping contest. We accommodated her, of course, but it slowed production of the videos quite a bit. By the end, we weren't using a stopwatch to time our videos. We'd switched to a calendar. Mary, I know you hired me to be company president because I'm a guy with a lot of great ideas. Well, here's another one. Ladies, no? No? It's just a minor change to the office. What do you think?
I love it.
Okay.
I love it.
And don't you think it's time we started discussing succession planning for the agency? I've been giving this some thought and believe you'll be pleased with the new roles some of us envision for you. We know how tiring work can be as people grow older. Oh, I went there. Oh, yeah. My senile grandfather. Get out of here. Yeah. So we plan a bit of office remodeling to create a space where you can recover. I'm assuming that's Tim also. Now, we realize we'll have to address the dress code too. Right, right, that's what I'm saying. We promise to have age-appropriate entertainment with characters you can identify with.
Yes! I love that!
We understand the need to continue to engage in intellectually challenging activities to keep your mind sharp, and we have several planned. Gotta love bingo, baby.
I gotta learn that.
And we have a fully stocked pantry of age-appropriate items just for you. Yes, Mary is truly a star at the Star Group. Just don't ask her to be at a meeting before 8:15 a.m. Mary Star, everybody. Now it's time for me to take on my favorite holy roller. My plan might not be perfect, but now I'm gonna aim high. I mean, like, heaven high. Dear God, please forgive me for what I'm about to do. But this event has led me astray. Where is my shepherd? How is he allowing this to happen? If he were close, wouldn't he do something? Except, he is close. Pastor Joel Howard, my spiritual mentor, is sitting right there. You might have already recognized him by his heavenly glow. I hope he'll forgive me as I go astray here at his expense. Now, Pastor Joel is quite a guy. Let's get it out there right now, though. He's a Chicago sports fan. Yes, one of those. Hey, Joel, those Bears are just killing it. They drafted Mitch Trubisky to be the next Aaron Rodgers.
Straight it up.
Well, He plays more like the Mr. Rogers my kids watch on PBS reruns. And the Cubs? Seriously, Joel, haven't you felt like one of the Hebrews wandering in the desert for what seemed like an eternity?
Do you have a championship ring?
You gotta bring the biblical reference in. No. You Chicago fans could probably use a superhero, which might help explain Joel's obsession with superheroes. Nothing wrong with that. My 5-year-old son feels the exact same way. If any of you think I'm exaggerating Joel's passion for those endowed with unique abilities, observe his fashion sense. Yes, that is a Captain America sport coat. Yes.
I like
it,
Joel.
See? I like it.
Come on! I didn't hear you come to my defense, Feldhusen. Seriously, though, I figured out Joel's superpower. An ability to talk more than anyone I know. Now, coming from me, a guy who pretty much defines verbose, that really says something. I mean, generally speaking, Joel is generally speaking. It's a superpower I see him exercise regularly. Now, it might not be on the same level as flying or x-ray vision, but hey, you play the cards you're dealt, right? Despite his monumental powers of verbosity, Joel isn't great at comebacks. I mean, throw a good verbal zinger at him and you might get a counterpunch emailed to you a week later. Any of you remember the jerk store episode of Seinfeld? You get the picture. Hey, Joel, the ocean called. It's running out of shrimp. Now, should have gone with the jerk store line. Now, we all know that every superhero has a weakness. Well, Joel's green kryptonite is Portillo's French fries. If Joel ever goes seriously astray, you can be sure Portillo's French fries are somehow involved. Now, Joel says he used to be quite the athlete. Well, he was a wrestler, for one. I'll bet nowadays the only wrestling he does is with his son David over the last Portillo's French fry. Now, Joel, you played basketball too, right?
Yep.
Is it true your basketball nickname was Mason? Something having to do with bricks?
Nope.
Maybe you can explain that one to me sometime. Now, I also mentioned Joel's son David. Well, did I mention that David has 5 older sisters? 5! That's 6 kids total. Joel, do you have another superpower you're not telling us about? Another thing you might not know about Joel is that he loves roller coasters. Well, with 6 women in his house, he's probably used to plenty of ups and downs on a daily basis. Well, that's the one that did it. He might not even need to go to an amusement park. Now, I mentioned Joel's supposed former athletic prowess. Well, Joel recently turned 40. If you want to get him a late birthday gift, I understand that Walgreens has a special on Just for Men. Yay, Walgreens. In support of Joel as he hits advanced age, our church recently hired a new associate pastor. His name is Zach, and he's 24. I keep having this vision of what happens when you bring a new puppy into a house that already has an old dog. Makes for some interesting interactions, doesn't it? Now, much to his credit, I haven't seen Joel growl at Zach. I'm waiting for the day, though, when Zach shows up with Portillo's French fries. It could be that day that Pastor Joel Howard is finally led astray. And if and when that day comes, Joel, just like you're here for me tonight, I'll be there for you, brother. Finally, if you're wondering where our church is headed with the new dynamic duo of Joel and Zach, the proof is in. See, Joel and Zach have these regular strategy sessions. It's just the two of them, and we often wonder what they talk about. Well, someone secretly filmed what was going on during one of their meetings, and here's what they discovered.
Oh, gosh.
You knew that was going to come back to get you. I'm not sure what to make of this, but there are lots of people here tonight who are smarter than me. So if you think there might be an issue, I guess all I can ask is, pray for us. Please, I think we might need it. Pastor Joel Howard, everybody. Now moving on to the final target, let's talk about Gary Loop. Yes. The incomparable Mr. Loop, my BFF. Yes, indeed, my big fumbling freak. What? That's not what BFF means to you? For those of you who don't know Gary, photogenic isn't an adjective usually applied to him. Nor is model quality. In fact, here's a few of the best photos we have of Gary Loop. Not exactly Brad Pitt, huh? Maybe his brother Armpit? Now, I really know the meaning of that old saying, looks aren't everything. If you value the safety of your mirrors, better keep this guy out of your house. For those of you who aren't aware, let me introduce you to Gary's beautiful wife, Jennifer. I know. You're kidding, right? No, I'm not. I think we've discovered the original odd couple. Or maybe the origin of that famous story, Beauty and the Beast? I mean, seriously, how does this happen? Gary, did she owe you money? Do you have some kind of serious dirt on her? Perhaps she's the founding member of the Have Mercy on Someone Club? Bad eyesight? Speaking of which, how many of you know Gary? Okay. So for many of you, this was your first time hearing Gary speak, right? Well, you have to agree, his voice is unique. Some would call it raspy. I liken it more to sandpaper smoking a cigarette. Gary, did you go overboard yelling at a Packers game one time and just never recover? Well, never fear, Gary. Career possibilities still await. How about working as a voiceover talent for advertisers? Just think of the possibilities. Maybe 1-800-STOP-SMOKING. Or asthma products. Or herbal tea remedies. Throat coat, anyone? Now, you might agree that music can connect us with a lot of things and events and people in our lives. Well, there's this certain song that always reminds me of Gary. Cue the music. Now, we talk about this all the time, so it's fair game. Some of you probably know that Gary suffered a stroke a couple years ago. Thank goodness he survived so that he can be here while we all enjoy some laughs at his expense. Now, I'm no doctor, but one has to wonder if one of the causes of Gary's stroke was his habit of drinking a gallon of chocolate milk a day. What? Who does that? Gary, were you deprived as a child and you're making up for lost time? Now, many of you might know that Gary used to be a stand-up comedian before his lovely wife, Jennifer, put him on the straight and narrow. Well, he's attempting a comeback. Now, I don't know how well it's going, though. Someone told me his audiences are reversing a famous line from Godfather 3. Just when he's getting into his act, they want to pull him back out. Now, if you're familiar with interventions, you know it's when a group of people get together to convince someone to stop doing something that's self-destructive. Well, maybe we need to do a career intervention with Gary, only in reverse. Instead of encouraging him to stop doing comedy, we want him to start being funny. It's a roast, boys and girls, come on. Now lastly, think about Gary's last name too. Loop. Substitute a P for the L and what do you have? Right. Poop. Don't you think a real comedian could get some mileage out of that? Reminds me of another time when I asked Gary if anyone had ever accidentally called his firm the Poop Group. He responded, "I don't give a crap." Yes, there's much to admire about our good friend Gary Loop. Just wake me when you find it and save me some leftover chocolate milk. Gary Loop, everybody. Now, I really appreciate all you coming out here tonight, and this has been more fun than I deserve to have. But here's where the fun ends, at least for you. Are the doors locked? No one can get out? Hold on, not yet. Are the doors locked? No one can get out? Okay, good. I wanted to make sure no one tried to get away from fully enjoying what's next. That's right. I'm gonna perform a little ditty.
Oh, no.
And there ain't nothing you can do about it. You're probably disappointed, aren't you? The special surprise is a roast of Paul M. Neuberger by Paul M. Neuberger. You'll probably recognize the tune, and I've customized the lyrics for tonight's shindig. Yes, because this is where we finish the entertainment in Paul's way. And now the time is near. We've locked the doors. You're staying here. A captive audience, that's what you are. Might want to make a run for the bar. My friends, I'm glad that you're here. And moving on, let's just make this clear. You'll hear what I have to say. Because, friends, this is Paul's way. My ego is surely none too small. My arrogance I can't hide, not at all. My voice perhaps a bit too loud. Maybe it's my need to stand out in a crowd. If these traits prove to be damnable, I've one sole defense, only one to say. It's who I am. Yes, this is me. And friends, this is Paul's way. Some like to say I talk too much. And as for them, I'll eat their lunch. I'll speak my mind if it takes all day. Just name the cost, it's a price I'll pay. Yes, hear me roar and quote this today. Here thus does Paul serve. I barely sleep. Far too much to do. Of restless nights, I've had more than a few. My energy, I know it's manic. I only pray it creates no panic. But I know God is on my side. Of this I'm certain, I've nothing to hide. I'll thump my Bible, yes, loudly each day. You've warned, this is Paul's word. My fashion sense might look askew. My conservative views may be missing a screw. My hairline is gone. No, it barely exists. Work myself to death. Yes, I've taken that risk. Just ask my wife. I have no life. And yes, this is Paul's word.
I've ruined Frank Sinatra on you forever now, didn't I?
Yes, you have.
In all seriousness, this brings us to the conclusion of the program. I just gotta say, obviously we're up here to roast and we're making fun of each other and teasing. I truly feel like the most blessed man on earth. I love each and every one of you. Thank you so much for coming out and supporting me, whether you're with C-Suite for Christ, the Star Group, my friends, family, whatever. You guys mean the world to me. Special thank you to Mary Starr for her awesome roast job. My brother from another mother, Pastor Joel Howard. And my best friend, Gary Luke. Feel free to stick around, enjoy some drinks, enjoy some fellowship. I love you guys so much. Thank you for being here. Appreciate it.
See you for another half hour if anybody wants pictures with you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Paul. Happy birthday to you.
There's cake in the back.
There's
cake in the back, and if anybody wants pictures with the good-looking Paul, he's standing right over there. Thank you. God bless.